What's up guys, Jason here, back at it again with another video. And for today's video guys, we will be reviewing and unboxing the iPhone SE 2020. I'm really sorry, it's been a long time since I last uploaded. I think it's been 3 or 4 weeks. I mean, look at my lion hair. Kitang-kita niyo naman na kailangan ko talaga magpag-upit. But enough of me. Let's get to the unboxing of the iPhone SE 2020. As you can see here in the front, you'll see the actual size of the iPhone SE 2020. And it is a familiar shape because this phone has the body of an iPhone 8. The variant I have here is the 128 gigs of internal storage, which is in the color black. I actually got this phone from Beyond the Box and Digital Walker, which would be available on their website and stores very soon. Now I know this is very familiar, especially if you've owned an iPhone before. The first thing you'll see here is this packet, which says designed by Apple in California. Inside there's paperwork that we don't really read, Apple stickers, and of course, the SIM tool. Next up is the phone itself, but let's set this aside for now. And inside are some earphones, the lightning cable, and the 5-watt power brick. I actually wanted to make a video about my first impressions when I first found out there is a new iPhone SE this 2020. But instead, I told myself that I would wait for this device to arrive. Okay, first impressions. Out of the box, this phone is very nostalgic. It's very lightweight, has a small screen, and fits at the palm of my hand. Well, people, especially guys like me who has huge hands, would not really appreciate a device this small. But despite it being small, I still wanted to give this device a chance because this might be an iPhone 8 on the outside, but this has iPhone 11 internals. Because I'm really curious, if you guys remember, my daily driver is an iPhone 11, and I want to find out if an A13 Bionic chip really makes this device as capable as my iPhone 11. The iPhone SE has exactly the same design and display as the iPhone 8 from 3 years back. And because of that, Apple has managed to keep the device's cost very low, as it didn't need to invest in a whole new manufacturing process. But I feel like people have long forgotten this phone design. As you all know, the newer iPhones have an all-screen design with a notch at the top. But this phone has a really thick forehead and a really thick chin. I do miss the home button though. But at certain times, I keep on swiping up instead of pressing the home button because I completely forgot that it exists here. But you know, we're still in the adjustment period, so we'll see. Returning to the iPhone 8 design means that Apple is bringing back its lightweight phones, and someone upgrading from the first iPhone SE will feel less of a change rather than changing from something like the iPhone 11 or the bigger iPhone 11 Pro Max. While the iPhone 8's design might feel like an odd choice for a new iPhone, it makes a lot of sense in the iPhone SE 2020. And for some who doesn't really care about the latest features, this more familiar design will be a lot more desirable. The display size of this iPhone is 4.7 inches and has a 720p resolution. Now, the display might not be the best on an iPhone, but given the target market for this phone, people who want an iPhone but don't want to spend a huge sum of money for it, you can't really expect an OLED screen. Now, the biggest change that shook a lot of people is this phone's internals, which has the A13 Bionic chip. You guys may call this a sleeper iPhone. It has old externals, but underneath, it has a supercharged monster. Now, why did I call this a sleeper phone? Some of you guys may know what the term sleeper is, especially if you're a car guy. A sleeper car is essentially a car that looks like shit, but the engine may surprise you as it runs like hell. Hence, I incorporated the term sleeper on this phone. And that extra power is designed to allow the new iPhone SE to rival the iPhone 11 range in terms of speed when flipping between apps and editing photos and videos, and should also improve the camera performance. But then again, even though it has an A13 Bionic chipset, it's not a phone for power users like me because it has a small battery. The battery didn't actually last me a whole day. I had to charge it twice, around in the afternoon and before I went to bed. And in that, please take note, I am not a heavy gamer. What else if gamers use this phone? Maybe it'll last them, I don't know, maybe 4 or 5 hours? And another problem about the small battery is the time it takes to get fully charged. In the box, it only includes a 5-watt charger, which I really don't recommend you using. And to solve the problem that I had with the charger, I got this. This is a Baseus, whatever, mini quick travel charger. And the good thing about this is this charger is 65 watts. It has two power delivery ports and a USB-A port. And what I like about this charger is it's not that bulky, unlike some chargers that deliver 65 watts. I mean, look at this. This is the standard iPhone power brick, and this is the Baseus 65 watt power brick. And what I really like about this power brick is, unlike some power bricks that deliver 65 watts, which are really bulky, this is compact. It doesn't really take a lot of space, and it fits right in my pocket. So whenever I travel, but I can't at the moment because it's still locked down, I only need to bring one charger for all of my gadgets. Again, to those who are curious, you can get this from Digital Walker or Beyond the Box. Setting this aside for now, let's go back to the phone and let's talk about its cameras. Now, the iPhone SE 2020 features a 12 megapixel camera with an aperture of f1.8. It may be a single lens setup, but because of the A13 Bionic chip, this iPhone now has portrait mode, which we really didn't have on the iPhone 8. I'm not that sad when I heard about the lack of a telephoto lens, but it saddened me when it didn't feature an ultra wide camera, because we all know that the iPhone 11 series has the best, if not one of the best, ultrawide cameras out there. Now for the front facing camera, it's the same 7 megapixel unit that we saw on the iPhone 7 and 8. It could also use the so-called retina flash, where your screen lights your face up in a particular color to provide more pleasing skin tones depending on the color of the available light. Now back to the main camera. You should also know that portrait mode only works on human subjects. It's not like the iPhone 11 or the iPhone 11 series, which could detect pets as well. The iPhone SE 2020 shoots very natural looking photos. The dynamic range and the contrast really surprised me. The colors are simply spot on, and when in good light, the noise is non-existent. Now for the price. For the 64GB variant, that costs 26,490 pesos. For the 128GB, that'll cost you 30,490, and for the 256GB, it's 10,000 pesos more expensive than the 64GB variant, which is 36,490 pesos. And that opens up the question, should you buy the iPhone SE 2020? For me, I have a few pros and cons. You should buy this iPhone SE 2020 because 1. You want a new great value iPhone. This is easily the best value iPhone. Not only is it the cheapest iPhone from Apple's lineup, but it also comes with Touch ID, an A13 Bionic chip, and is nearly half the price of an iPhone 11. 2. You want a small phone, and this phone easily fits in the palm of your hand, unlike newer phones which are really big and bulky to bring, and you can't even put some in your pocket. Now for the cons. You shouldn't buy this iPhone if you, 1. Value battery life. Again, as I've said earlier, this phone didn't really last me the whole day. I only used it for about 4 to 5 hours, and I needed to charge it twice. 2. You shouldn't buy this if you want the best pictures from an iPhone. Picture quality is okay, but it's not like the flagships, which has the ultra wide mode, a portrait mode that detects pets, and even though I'm not actually using it frequently, a telephoto lens. And the last reason why you shouldn't buy this phone is because you want a big screen. For me, I always watch movies on the go, so it doesn't really suit me to have a smartphone that has a 4.7-inch screen. So that is it for the unboxing and quick review of the iPhone SE 2020. Again, thanks for watching, see you in the next one. Bye guys!